Hey, it's Scott from SupplyHouse.com, and in this video, we're going to talk about dielectric unions. When your hot water heater hooks up to your water pipes, it actually creates a problem. When two different metals are connected together in the presence of an electrolyte, in this case tap water, you get a reaction called galvanic corrosion. This means that atoms from one metal break off and cling to other metal. To avoid this, plumbers use a special coupling called a dielectric union. It's a coupling that acts as an electrical barrier between the two metals. One side is made of copper, the other steel. Between the two sides, there is a non-conducting washer, usually made of rubber, which prevents the metals from interacting. Dielectric unions are required by code in most states. DEUs will sometimes corrode after 10 plus years on the job. However, if the DEU corroded, it means your tank didn't. In some states, it is acceptable under code to use a brass connection between the steel of the water heater and copper water pipes. A brass fitting is marginally less reactive with steel than copper. Since dielectric unions have become code, some water heater manufacturers have actually been building dielectric connections into their heaters. In these dielectric nipples, the steel pipe is lined with the dielectric barrier. For more information, visit the Resource Center at SupplyHouse.com or email us with any questions.